The Dutch secondary school system is rather complicated, and all the acronyms you come across when trying to understand the school options for your child do not make it any easier. In this video, Annabeth van Mamer from Nieuw2NL will take you by the hand and guide you through the process. It is a long story, but hopefully afterward you and your children will feel more confident taking the right decisions around their education. After group 8 of primary school, when most children are 12, they transfer to secondary school. In Dutch, this is called middelbare school. There are three types of secondary school, and they go by the following acronyms: VMBO, HAVO, and VWO. Regardless of the type of school, students finish by taking a national exam. In the Netherlands, school attendance is compulsory for all children aged 5 to 18, or until they have a diploma for at least MBO, HAVO, or VWO, which is the so-called START qualification. The end test of primary school. How does a child end up at a VMBO, HAVO, or VWO school, you might wonder? The teacher of group 8 gives the recommendation for which type of school would suit each pupil best. They base this recommendation on the child's test score since group 6, their interest, intelligence, motivation, eagerness to learn, ambitions, maturity, etc. The teacher's recommendation, advies in Dutch, comes in February. Sometimes teachers give a combined recommendation, for example VMBO and HAVO, or HAVO and VWO. Then the pupils apply for secondary school, which offers the level that the teacher has recommended. A couple of months later, in April, the pupils take the end test for primary school, which contains questions about math, spelling, and comprehensive reading. The test for world orientation, a combination of history, biology, geography, and world religions, is optional. Some of the more religious schools have opted out because of the questions about other religions. There are 5 test providers approved by the Ministry of Education. Maybe you have heard about the CITO test before. This is one of them. All schools are obliged to get their pupils to take the end test, but they may choose which version suits their pupils best. If the test results are higher than the teacher's recommendation, the secondary school recommendation may be upgraded. However, if the test results are lower, the teacher's recommendation does not change. There are currently a lot of discussions about the timing of the test in relation to the teacher's recommendation. Some children would benefit if there was less time in between. Hopefully, this will change in the near future. Types of secondary education. So, what do all those acronyms actually stand for? VMBO stands for pre-vocational education, which is called voorbereidend middelbaar beroepsonderwijs in Dutch. This type of education takes 4 years. VMBO students specialize in 1 of 4 sectors, combining general and vocational education: technical, agriculture, economics, or care and welfare. Just over 50% of students attend a VMBO school. With a VMBO diploma, you may proceed to senior secondary vocational education, called middelbaar beroepsonderwijs, or MBO, to learn a profession. The MBO study takes 1 to 4 years, depending on the level and field of study. After MBO, you may move on to HBO, which is University of Applied Sciences, if you wish. After VMBO, you may also stream into the penultimate, the 4th year of HAVO. In a little while, I'll explain what jobs you could get with which diploma. Hopefully it will become less abstract then. HAVO is the abbreviation of Hoger Algemeen Voortgezet Onderwijs, which stands for Senior General Secondary Education. Over 5 years, the students prepare for University of Applied Sciences, called HBO or Hogeschool. With a HAVO diploma, you may also stream into the penultimate, the 5th year of VWO. Under certain conditions, after your first year at HBO, you may move on to university, also called WO. Or you may follow your bachelor's study at HBO and your master's at university, if this is what you're aiming for. About 24% of students follow a HAVO education. The final type is VWO, which stands for Voorbereidend Wetenschappelijk Onderwijs, and translates as Preparatory Scientific Education. This takes 6 years and prepares students for education at a research university. To make it even more complex, there are 2 types of VWO, Gymnasium and Atheneum. The difference between the two is that Gymnasium students are obliged to study Latin and Ancient Greek language and culture, and to take their final exams in at least one of these languages. However, in the end, Gymnasium students obtain the same VWO diploma as Atheneum students. Some people think that you need to have a Gymnasium diploma to, for example, study medicine at university. However, this is not true. About 22% of students go to VWO. Subject cluster choices in HAVO and VWO. The last 2 years for HAVO or 3 years for VWO form the exam preparation phase. During these years, students focus on 1 of 4 subject clusters, called profielen or profiles, each of which concentrates on a certain field of study. You may choose between science and technology, natuur en techniek in Dutch, science and health, natuur en gezondheid, economics and society, economie en maatschappij, or culture and society, cultuur en maatschappij. Next to these subject clusters, the students also follow compulsory subjects like Dutch and English language and literature, plus at least 1 other foreign language at VWO, often German or French. Furthermore, they have to take some type of math, social studies, and cultural and artistic education, as well as physical education. Finally, the students must take a number of electives and write a research paper about a topic related to their chosen subjects. In the final year of HAVO, students need to take their national exams in at least 7 subjects, and VWO students in 8 subjects. Brugklas. Many secondary schools combine different streams in the first year, which they call brugklas, which means bridge class. Here they combine, for example, VMBO and HAVO, or HAVO and VWO. This gives the pupils 1 more year to make up their minds and to demonstrate the level at which they are capable of performing. In some secondary schools, this decision is made after 2 years. In the third year, the 3 types of schools become considerably different. A couple of schools have taken part in a pilot project which offers their students more flexibility in terms of following different subjects at different levels or moving to a higher stream after only 2 years of education. It would be nice if this became more common in the near future. Philosophies, religions and profiles. Like many primary schools, there are also many secondary schools that are based on a religion: Protestant, Catholic, Muslim or Jewish, or an educational philosophy like Montessori, Waldorf or Dalton. It is common that in the event of oversubscription, for example, a Montessori school for secondary education gives priority to pupils who come from a Montessori primary school. But you may also apply to the school when you have attended a different type of primary education. For most religious schools, you don't have to be religious yourself, but there are some exceptions. Make sure to check in advance with your school of interest. Some schools, known as profile schools, have a special focus on culture, sports, arts or languages. There are also some bilingual schools, called TTO schools. In the first 3 years, they teach half of the subjects in Dutch and the rest in English. All the final exams are in Dutch though, so during the last 2 or 3 years they switch back to more Dutch. This type of school is often not suitable for students who have not fully mastered the Dutch language yet. Cost. Like almost all primary schools, most secondary schools are funded by the government. The tuition is free. Usually, the school asks for a parental contribution to pay for things like school trips, camps, and cultural activities. The average amount is about 550 euros per year and is voluntarily. Parents who cannot afford the fee may ask the municipality for a subsidy. Although the school books for secondary education are free, the students have to buy the school supplies themselves, A laptop or tablet is often handy too. Admission to HBO or university. Studying in the Netherlands might be a good idea. Higher education in the Netherlands is of a high standard. All 13 state-funded Dutch universities score well in the Times Higher Education World University Rankings. When you apply for university or HBO, the admissions department will check your diploma and whether you have followed the right subject cluster to start a bachelor program. If you are missing a certain subject, there is often a possibility to take a summer class, concluded by a certificate for the missing course. In most cases, you don't need to sit an entrance exam for university. However, some studies have a numerous fixes, which means that there is a maximum number of students they can accept per year. In this case, a selection procedure takes place, which varies per university and per course. They are usually interested in the grades of your secondary school diploma, your motivation and previous working experience in the area of your prospective study. The name or reputation of your secondary school doesn't play a role in this process. There are no specific schools that give you higher chances of getting a place at university compared to any other school. In the past, numerous fixed places were allocated by a random lottery. It seems very likely that this procedure will return, since it is more objective and, so to speak, equally unfair for everyone. More and more university courses are offered in English, and they often also admit students who have, for example, an IB or A-level diploma. The website studyfinder.nl gives you a good overview of the study courses offered in English. Also good to know, anyone aged 21 or over may take the so-called colloquium doctum exam to gain access to university without having the necessary secondary school diplomas. Most universities worldwide accept students with a VWO diploma and sometimes even also with a HAVO diploma. They might have additional requirements, for example proficiency in the local language and or having passed your secondary school exam with high grades. Study costs. Almost all Dutch university courses are state-funded, and students from the Netherlands and the EU pay a contribution of €2,143 per year, while most first-year students pay half price. You might also qualify for study grant or loan, based on, among other things, your performances and your parents' income. Students from outside of the EU pay more. In this case, the university may decide on its own fees. Professions. Finally, I discuss what jobs you could get after which type of education. When applying for a job in the Netherlands, most companies will ask you for your qualifications and diplomas. Therefore, it's often better to have, for example, an MBO diploma, rather than drop out of university with nothing. Especially at MBO and HBO levels, many employers require very specific qualifications and specializations from their future employees. In this case, they would maybe prefer an HBO or MBO graduate to someone who has a master's degree. What can you become with your MBO, HBO or university diploma? In general, MBO graduates are professionals who work in more vocational professions. For a lot of HBO level jobs, you need to have graduated from university in other countries. And what we call university prepares people for more academic and research-oriented jobs. There are also some studies that are offered at multiple levels. For example, you can become a nurse with an MBO diploma, but when you have studied nursing at HBO level, you will be more likely to end up in a managerial role in healthcare. Of course, there are many more possible professions than listed below, but just to give you an idea. With your MBO diploma, you could become an assistant, secretary, security officer, office employee, hairdresser, nurse or childminder. After graduating from HBO, you could, for example, work as a teacher, accountant, manager, team leader, banker, architect, art director, journalist, translator, realtor, engineer, advisor, consultant, midwife, artist, or pilot. University prepares students for jobs like lawyer, psychologist, doctor, surgeon, specialist, expert, researcher, notary, professor, engineer, or scientist. Hopefully by now the Dutch education system sounds less complex to you. If you have any further questions, I welcome you to book a video call through newtonl.com/families. enjoy your life and study in the Netherlands.